So I hope we're all ready to move on to the second panel session for the day. Yeah, I know that we get a tad bit sleepy after lunch, but I hope that's not the case today. Yeah, I think we had a really hearty lunch, but we're going to really enjoy ourselves. So this session, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be moderated by Aditi NC, founder, CEO, the social unicorn. And with us on the panel, we have Mr. Pritesh Chauthani, co-founder and CEO, HIVOCO, Education and Learning, Vaishali Shah, CEO and Creative Head, Moving Pixels Private Limited, with Mr. Prabhveer Sahme, Senior Director, Samsung Ads, India and Southeast Asia, Samsung, along with Mr. Faizan Ahmad, National Head, Digital Transformation, Revenue, on behalf of the Hindu, and Mr. Rohit Uttam Chandani, founder, Techeon. Well, this session is about learning and unlearning, the need for constant innovation. Can we please put our hands together for everyone who's about to join us? Louder, please. Come on. Thank you.
Hello and a very warm welcome. My name is Aditi NC. I'm the founder of the Social Unicorns. Thank you for joining in. And we are going to start with the session because we are running a little late. So I would request all the panelists to kindly introduce themselves.
So I'll go first. My name is Pritesh. I'm the co-founder and CEO of a kids brand, a kids entertainment brand called HiVoco, which stands for High Voice Companion. We are the world's first voice-enabled, voice-interactive animated stories app for children. And we've done, in the past 6 months, we've done some great work. I've been in this business of marketing communication and being a P&L leader for about 15 years. I've been at Coke, Whirlpool. I was a business leader at Radio Mirchi, and now I'm an entrepreneur. So happy to join here with all the panelists.
Namaste, I'm Vaishali Shah, CEO of the Moving Pixels Company. We are a film production house and a design studio. We expert in political advocacy. I started my career as a copywriter. Today, I'm doing almost everything I'm supposed to do, and karma hi dharma is the mantra of my life. Thank you.
Hi. My name is Prabhveer. I represent Samsung Ads. We are setting up the first of its kind CTV ad networks for India and Southeast Asia. And given this topic is around change, I've always happened to be at a point in change in industry, and CTV happens to be one of them. Thank you for being a part of this event.
Hi, my name is Rohit Uttam Chandani. I'm the founder of Techeon. We are a digital marketing and transformation consulting company. Personally, I've been in the digital space for over a decade. Worked with multiple brands across sectors, across India and the Middle East, helped them craft digital strategies, scale their online presence, done a lot of workshops, done over 200 workshops for leading corporates across India, Middle East, and Africa, where we've helped their teams build capability in digital. They say you shouldn't blow your own trumpet too much, so I will stop and look forward to being part of the panel.
Hey, hi. Myself, Faizan. I'm working with the Hindu Group as a digital transformation head for revenue function. So we are trying to build an integrated sales for the organization. Look forward.
Thank you. So today we are talking about learning and unlearning, the constant need for innovation. And innovation means value creation, basically. Having said that, when we talk about innovation and organization, to begin with, Faizan, how to create, what are your views on how to create a culture where risk-taking and experimentation is allowed in an educated and confident manner?
Okay, thanks Aditi. So before I move into how to create a culture of experimentation, I'll just give you my understanding what basically learning and unlearning means to us. And I personally believe this is not something which is new, and this was always there with us. You think about your childhood, once we first stepped on to schools, how we started learning with the help of fingers, 1, 2, 3. When we grew further, an abacus was introduced. And what we have noticed, every time a new technique is being introduced, you have to leave away the old fashion, and we have seen the way we respond to that particular thing. So I personally feel that this learning, unlearning, and relearning is a perfect combination of what you call an awareness, intellectual humility, and curiosity. Anyone would like to go forward at. Anybody will strive for. And what we used to discuss about 3 years, 4 years back, we used to discuss about IQ level of a person, emotional quotient, maybe an execution quotient, but now the new term, the learnability quotient, is finding its way. It's finding its way. If you are not ready to unlearn, somebody will come and replace you. Being an individual, we need to ask a question to ourselves. What we want to create, whether we want to create an experience for multiple years or one experience for multiple years. There is a huge difference. So if you want to create an experience, you need to make certain changes. You need to have trust on your people. I belong to a sales fraternity and everybody knows. In sales, people will come, ki danda chalao, bande bhagenge, danda leke aayenge. Trust me, this methodology is no longer going to work. What will happen if you scream at people? Next time they are not going to improve. They are just going to hide the fact. As an individual, it's our responsibility, it's an organization responsibility to create a safe environment for them. We have to plan for action. Mistakes will happen. No, nobody can predict what will happen in the future unless and until you try. And unless and until you don't create a safe environment, don't ask your people to create something new. If you start penalizing your people, you are never going to achieve a success. And I would like to quote one of the quote by Alan Joseph, what he says. He says, the illiterate of 21st centuries are not those who don't know how to read and write, but would be the one who don't know how to learn, unlearn, and relearn.
Very, very well put, Faizan. Thank you. Praveer, coming to you, what do you think about reinventing oneself with the action of learning and unlearning and relearning?
Well, I do sometimes have the allergic reaction to the word unlearning, simply because I do believe there's a statement in our community called Dadi Maa Ke Nuske. So we should not forget some of the foundational elements that we've learned over the course of our lives. And if you've read the book called Sapiens, which right. is on history, Yuval Harari quite nicely said that history is not study of time, but it's study of change. So that means that this very moment, we are part of a change any which way. But the way I interpret change in my own personal evolution from wanting to be a chef to now doing digital marketing has been that willingness to learn, as he quite rightly said. And also have the understanding that you need to adapt to survive. And if you miss any of these elements, I think learning, unlearning, and relearning can quite easily fall apart. So know your fundamentals, know that you have to survive. And in that mindset, be agile and adaptive to whatever is happening around you. And you can choose to reject something because it may not suit your value system, but that's perfectly fine. But be here for the longer time and be here for good for everybody.
Right, thank you. Rohit, what do you think about it? I mean, do you have something, just a value addition?
Yeah. So like Praveer said, right, we are in a time of great change, and change is all around us. Everything we do in this world is changing at a rapid pace, and something I've seen in the digital space itself, digital is a space which changes really fast. In fact, I remember someone saying this, that the pace of change that we have today has never been faster and will never be slower here on. So it's the pace of change is only growing. And in a space like this, if you don't have that skill to be able to unlearn and then learn, and just to give you an example there in the digital space itself, right? I'm not sure how many of you are, most of you might be running Google search ads for your brand, right? If you optimize a Google search ad today with your knowledge from 1 year ago, right, you would not get the same results and your results would not be optimal, because in the last 1 year, so much has changed in that space itself. And this applies to almost everything in digital, whether it's a Google search ad or a Facebook ad, there are new features coming every day, there are new tactics. The way you do it today is very, very different from sometimes even 6 months back. Right? So for most of these teams in digital, you require to, the skill is very important. It's the ability to kind of let go of what you've learned before. And that comes a little difficult to us, is what I've seen sometimes in a lot of teams, is you are so connected to something you've done, and I've seen especially teams in digital agencies sometimes, you've been doing the same thing for 5 years and you think that's what works. And then you're not able to let go of that and start fresh. This ability to let go and start fresh is something that's a critical skill in a digital world, the pace at which we're changing. So it's absolutely important for every company to build that culture in its team.
Right, so in digital age, when we are trying to upskill, what is working today is definitely going to go obsolete in the next 6 months. Right, Pritesh, your take on this.
Yes, sure. So we all are speaking about how, as an individual, we need to change. But as a leader, as a manager, I think it's a primary responsibility towards our employees to actually make the change happen for them. And I primarily believe that, you know, usually employees would have a smog in front of them, not knowing really what the essential change is going to be. See, understand, all of us are, as employees, are working hard to, you know, achieve our immediate results. Next month ka target kya hai, or how many views do I need to get as a content creator and stuff like that. The macro changes that are happening is only visible at, you know, 15,000 feet or 30,000 feet. And as a leader, therefore, you know, one has to create that culture of, you know, giving the power to the employee and saying, listen, I understand you're doing something right here and you're learning and you're doing well. But now I want you to take up something new and I won't question you for next 12 months. But you have to go basis my conviction that you have the ability to do that. Once you see a manager or a leader give a conviction, you would see this culture of, you know, innovation naturally come out. Obviously, you need support in terms of, you know, training the employees and creating those resources. However, it is the conviction of the manager and the support that you give to the employee, you would see the whole, you know, culture of innovation fostering in an organization.
Right. So basically, training your workforce as well, which will help in, you know,
I agree. So, not only just training the workforce, but the first step in actually getting someone to say, hey, listen, I speak from experience. We used to do a lot of, so I used to head business for Radio Mirchi, and primarily, you know, best minds in radio creating great content. But if you want to push someone saying, listen, I want you to now focus 50% of your energies creating digital, what do you do? In terms of saying, but mera to rating kharab ho jayega. But no, that's not the point. I would protect you for what you've done. In the next 6 months, 12 months, I won't even give you a rating for, you know, the stuff that you do on digital, and monitor your performance as a trend line and not as a point in time. Right. So therefore, you know, and training is part of it. But the whole conviction of getting someone to move from just doing what they were, you know, doing core for themselves to moving something that they have to do for the organization. Because the organization has to move from one of the core, you know, core businesses to new businesses. You have to give your assets that stimulation to believe in themselves to get this thing done.
Right. So thank you so much, Pritesh. So moving on, Vaishali. So this is something that I really wanted to know, that you know, a company which reflects a company culture which reflects ethics, values, and you know, goals, brand goals also. Do you think it is a reflection of a great campaign? I mean, a great campaign reflects the company's culture?
Yeah, so again, I would like to begin this with the term learning and unlearning. See, because learning and unlearning is not just one person's culture, it's the culture of the whole organization. It should be the culture of the whole organization. Then only one person's dream becomes a shared dream, and together they can grow, together they can achieve it. About unlearning, at least, you know, at least one thing we all can unlearn every morning is the realization that yesterday what I did was the best and how to forget it today. And at least one thing we all can learn every evening is that tomorrow whatever I'm going to do has to be the best. And unlearning is not about forgetting our skills, but it's about reminding our skills every day to work harder and to think broader. And to me, I'm giving my opinion, unlearning is challenging the subset attitude. You know, it's about coming out of our comfort zones.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and unlearning, see, it's unlearning is not a time-taking process. It's not a meditation, it's a quick decision. It's a quick shift from what's next to what's new.
Right.
Yeah. And another thing I would like to say, See, learning and unlearning, they are the parallel process. They happen parallelly like we do in a freestyle swimming. It happens parallel. And I'll give you an example that when I'm briefing my creative team, my first line begins with, let's do it better than the last time. Here I'm not giving any big fund on filmmaking or content marketing, nothing. But together we are setting a target that we want to do it better than last time, that innovation becomes a compulsion. You have no other option than to do it differently and with whatever resources you have right now.
So when you're creating a campaign for your clients with your team, do you keep in mind the company's profile, as in company's culture? I mean, what kind of value system they believe in? Do you believe it? I mean,
yeah, culture is an inevitable part of any process, you know, be it campaign or construction or anything. So we, like we at Moving Pixels, we believe in, that unlearning and relearning is our culture. That's why I'm talking so much on it. Right. Because we are never in illusion that we are the best. My writer would never say that I'm the best writer, right, the best editor, the best marketer, because it's an illusion. If anyone believes that, it's an illusion and right, it's not reality. It can never be a reality. So, right, yeah, it's a culture that we all share.
Thank you, Vaishali. Rohit, coming to you, your take on how you see it, as in a great campaign is a reflection of a great company culture. Do you believe in that?
Yeah, I'll talk about it more from the perspective, not from a brand campaign perspective,
right,
but more of from, let's say, because I work a lot on the performance side of things. So more from a performance campaign perspective, what I do see is, yes, of course, culture is important. And because I work with a lot of clients from an external perspective and I get to study what their culture is internally, and I also get to see the results they get. So it goes without saying, and I have data to say that companies where they have a culture of unlearning and learning, a culture of experimentation, a culture of constantly trying to do things in a new or better way, are the companies where their overall campaign or marketing ROI turns out to be the best. Their campaigns run the most optimally. To give you an example is, for example, I've seen companies where when, let's say, they want to build a team to experiment and do new things, they probably invest in tools. So I've seen companies where they spend a lot of money buying the best tools, without first building that culture of experimentation. So what happens there is you have a lot of money that's spent without first having a team that understands how to hypothesize, how to look at what do we need to test before using the tool to test. Right? So a lot boils down to the culture we're building, right? From innovation to experimentation.
Right. Thank you so much, Rohit. Moving on, so there was something that we were talking about, Faizan. We would really want you to share about, firewalling the stereotypes when it comes to clients' transformation.
Okay, that's the interesting thing to discuss, and I have something which I am currently doing as far as breaking the stereotype is concerned. So every time when you witness now, if you ask, even in the room, if you ask, how many wants change? I think most than 90% of the people will raise the hand, hey, I want change. The moment you ask the second question, how many of you wants to change, then the real problem arises. Everybody wants change, but nobody wants to get themselves changed. And I personally believe, what is the biggest hindrance in changing yourself? Trust me, it's the knowledge and the skill sets. What you possess now is the biggest hindrance. Mere ko sikhayega, main 20 saal se yehi kar raha hu. And that's the there. It's the illusion of knowledge, not the knowledge which holds you in getting the change. And when it comes to breaking a stereotype now, when I entered into a digital space while working for a print media for almost 3 and 4 years, then I moved to a digital space doing sales and building advertising revenue for them. So when we go and say, people will say, hey, to sell digital, you need to be X skill sets, Y skill sets, Z skill sets is required. When we go and talk to the organization, hey, print people can't sell digital. So then we thought, they are the one who understand the organization far more better than I do. I may be understanding the medium, but print people are the subject matter, are the market matter experts. They are there into the market for quite so longer period of time. They have a better connect with the brand and the agency. And digital person are those who is the, what you call a subject matter expert. Why not to marry them? We break that stereotype and what you call it, dismantled our entire digital sales team. Now we have one integrated sales team within the Hindu. If you want to give them a term, you can call them a digital sales people. But is it only just setting up the goal is good enough? No. We just don't want to change, we want to harness it. Then what we have done, we have set up a unit called Digital Center for Excellence. Now what this will do? My people understand Hindu, they understand Hindu ethics, they don't understand digital as a medium. So we have established an in-house training center for them. So we select 12 to 14 people from the entire print sales team and train them for entire 3 years. And that training happens from the internal instructor. And I'm happy to share that this has really done wonders for us, and we were able to move down our digital advertising revenue by almost 400% in the last 2 years. So as a leader, we just don't have to make changes. We have to ensure we are harnessing those changes, making progress, taking learning. Then again, if that learning is not good for us, unlearn them and then go for the another learning.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Faizan. So thank you for your valuable inputs, panelists. Thank you so much. And we are now open to questions from the audience.
Thank you so very much. Can we have a huge round of applause, please? Yeah, I'd like to request Mr. Gaurav Pahwa, VP Sales, VServe, to please come.
Hi, Faizan. I'm Shagun, and my question is to you. Considering the newspaper and the media industry, how the news is consumed within not even hours, it's a minute game. So this question is primarily that how traditional media is gonna be there, because by the time I get a newspaper next day in house, I've already consumed the news. It's a matter of like 2-3 hours. So how the next day after 24 hours when I'm consuming the data, which has already been there on digital world. So what will be the future for the the traditional media, specifically newspaper and magazine industry?
That's a tricky one. But I will share you my views, how I basically see the entire print media and a digital media. So you correctly mentioned digital media, it's on the go. You can read it whenever you want to. But have you tried to understand why people prefer print and why still most of the marketer love to advertise on print? I try to understand it from a psychological point of view. So our mind is positioned like we have two parts to it, a subconscious and a conscious mind. So if you try and understand the reading behavior of yours, you will always read the newspaper at a stipulated time. So the time is defined maybe in the morning while having tea, cup of coffee. So when you read any particular newspaper, you are just positioned to read and consume the content. Your engagement level is much more higher. Correct. So print is going to be there. Print is going to be there. Because when it comes to digital, sometimes you are confused whom to follow. Same news, you are reading it on multiple platforms. The views you are reading on multiple platforms. So I think it's the engagement which will define the print, the print in the future. And it's going to be there. It's going to be there. Then circulation might come down. But it's going to be there, very much there.
Sure. Thank you.
I would like to add to this that there is a difference between news and views, where we find everything easily on any platform, or maybe not they may be just views, but the traditional mediums give you news, and it's not about just news, it's about who is giving the news. There is a legacy of credibility behind that piece of news.
If I have 1 minute, I would like to add one more point. How many of you believed 3 years back Indian consumer won't pay for content? I think almost all of us. Hindustani content ke paise nahi denge, free ka available hai. Hamare paas n number of sources are available to consume the content. But look the way subscription is going on. We as an organization have taken that bold step of moving our product behind the paywall 2 years back. And trust me, we are doing successfully, really well in that particular area. Consumer will pay for the content, but you have to ensure what kind of content we generate. So content will always remain the king. And as correctly mentioned, Vaishali, is the views what people would love to get for.
Sure, thank you.
just something that I felt we should add here as well. One common thing I've seen in digital forums, right, is, and not nothing with what you said, but generally in digital forums, is a lot of these blanket statements, right? Print is dead, TV is dead. So one thing that I've seen, a common mistake that marketers in general make, is assuming that you are your target audience, right? Or your target audience behaves the way you behave. And I've seen this across brands, brand managers. Everyone says, okay, I wouldn't go there, so maybe my target audience would not be there either. So with same thing with both print and TV, right? Both are continuing to flourish. With print, I have clients that continue to do print ads, not purely because of the ROI, but because of the perception. I have a client that wanted to do a print even though when they knew that it's not going to give them the same ROI had they put the same money in digital. But they still wanted to do it because for them it's like our brand is on the front page of Times of India. The perception that creates is a lot more than anything else I would want to get out of that money. So that is one. And just to add to that, I am a digital native. I've been a digital first marketer. But every morning I still pick up my print copy of TY. You can call me a dinosaur if you want. But the reason I do that, I have a reason I do that, because that's one time in the day when I'm not using my phone and I'm reading off paper. So I do it for that, but and I'm assuming there are people who do that as well. So.
Right, I want to echo the same point. When people say that print is dead, even when we see the digital tools like blogging is dead, it's very important for people to understand it's not dead. Everything is evolving, and so is the print. So, yes, I mean, it takes time. It's a gradual, evolution. But
and
it
see,
is
I'm sorry, but I need to make one point here.
Sure, please.
I'll take just one more minute. See, digital, print, television, they are just mediums. But at the heart remains content. So if the content is strong, so be it on print, be it on digital, it is surely going to connect. So we focus so much on the medium. The print is dead or alive and digital is buzzing, but we don't really give that much of importance to the content. So mediums are always evolving, as you rightly said, but the content since ages, uska apna hi charm hai, iska apna hi value. Content adds value to the medium. Medium, I don't think, adds much value to content. I don't think koi film digital pe release hone se bahut badhiya ban gayi aur theater mein aane se wo gir gayi. I mean, it's just the, apna ek selling strategies. Yeah.
Such a wonderful question, right? Everybody has a perspective. And I'd like to completely disagree with Vaishali, saying content is not as important as the medium is, because content to kahin bhi ja sakta hai, right? It's the, if you are a business leader, if you are the owner of the company, you are focusing only on the platform or the distribution medium. If you own the distribution medium, you will be successful. If you're not owning it, you will always play in a content game, which is always a low margin business. So we've seen print guys struggle because that was a legacy distribution business, right? Nobody could enter. There'll be only two or three players in that market, right? But as a content creator, just switch on your camera and you can start creating content. And you're creating content for Facebook, for YouTube, for TikTok, right? So as a business owner, obviously the crowd here would resonate. You would always want to see the play between content and distribution, what side of coin that you are most interested in. As a business leader, I'm more interested in the distribution, less on the content, because content to ban jata.
All right. Thank you so much. Thank you for
content brings
we
money.
All agree to disagree. Yeah, always. And I think it contributes to great health in conversation and perspective. Thank you so very much. Well, I'd like to now invite Mr. Gaurav Pawa, VP Sales, VServe, to please give a token of appreciation to our esteemed panelists. Can we please put our hands together? We already have our next panel team ready.